Once again, I am John Ratz, and I am from Creighton Prep. I used to dream horribly, and what was nearly always a shade of nightmare, nothing scared me more than my own mind. When I was young, I feared not the monsters beneath my bed, but the darkness that poured itself inside my head. I trusted that I had God above me and the wicked below me. What this meant, I did not know, only that I suffered and the gap between them and the sky seemed so far away. I learned that the cure for a terrified mind is to sleep with a Bible tucked beneath the pillow. I did not feel a saving grace radiating up from the good word through cloth and stuffing. All I felt was extremely uncomfortable. You try sleeping atop the sacred text of millennia-old faith and tell me how you feel in the morning. Regardless of how weird it was, this was how I slept for years, until I almost forgot that the sacred word of God, Jesus, and pals was stashed beneath my head, but I no longer sat up sweating in the night and the screams of my subconscious faded to wisps on waking. Still, the night I finally decided to remove my heavenly headrest was the best sleep I have ever had. If my method sounds a little strange, it should. A stable person wouldn't sleep on a book. I have now managed my mind for longer than I suffered from either terrors or a talisman. Those years, and the closest I ever was to God because I slept next to him every night. I was the kind of kid who would go to church alone, run crying to confession at the mere mention of a breast, condemn homosexuals when I only knew the dictionary definition, and abhor abortion without a second thought. Years later, and some things have changed. I look upon my past as its own kind of nightmare until the world shocked me awake. You see, my parents sent me to a good Catholic high school to carry on the family tradition of faith. It took 2 years to turn me into a godless, pro-choice, equality advocate apostate, the kind of demon pundits declare apart the generation destined to cut out the pure Christian heart of our nation and devour it whole in some satanic ritual known only as progress. Because when the religious insist that my sister, whose body and mind unravel at the seams, who falls to the ground and quakes with seizures the Bible would call demonic possession, a girl who once asked, tears streaming from the eyes that were going blind, why is God doing this to me? It's simply an extra test from some supreme being to make me more compassionate, because everything happens for a reason. It would be easier to punch them in the face, as if her life was a lesson. Instead, I droop out some essence of the trembling child of not long ago when I insist, if God exists, he will have to beg for my forgiveness.